It takes a lot of tests to devise rods with extraordinary balance and distribution of power, rods that make playing a fish exciting and full of action. It takes a team of knowledgeable executives to keep the team of fishermen and his equipment in smooth and happy operation. The men here are intimately acquainted with the sport of fishing, as well as with the business of producing quality rods. Among them, they cover just about every type of fishing possible, learning problems firsthand. Every Garcia Conolon rod is customized, produced by hand as a single unit. After the rod is designed, patterns are cut from reinforced fiberglass cloth. The cloth and safety flag are now bound to the pre-coated mandrel, affixed with an enduring adhesive of phenolic resin. The tapered steel mandrel will help shape the design of the fishing rod. Each component part of that rod must be perfectly suited to play its role in achieving predetermined action, durability, appearance, and ease of handling. The glass cloth pattern is rolled around the mandrel to form the rod. The size of the patterns will determine the flexibility of the finished product. This is the application of cellophane, which creates pressure around the cloth during the curing. It seals it off so that it may be cooked inside. After curing, the mandrel is removed. In this step, on the long and careful road toward production of a fishing rod that comes alive in the hands, the cutting and polishing takes place. It takes meticulous work every step of the way to build a rod with extraordinary balance and distribution of power. At this point, a skilled worker grinds the safety flag down to size to fit the special ferrules that will be blended into each rod to attain perfect action under all types of usage. Painting not only adds to eye appeal, but it is also a colorful index for marketing purposes. Now the rods must be ferruled. The ferrules are created by hand from a special brass alloy for perfect fit and super strength while light in weight. The ferrules must blend perfectly into each rod to ensure perfect action. Building the handle for the rod is a meticulous operation that requires know-how born of experience. When completed properly, the handle must have a sure feel to the ardent angler, giving him a grip that is both secure and yet flexible enough to shift with the action called for. This young lady is fitting two pieces of cork together so they will fit the long saltwater rod in perfect concentric fashion. It is attention to details like this which spell the difference between an ordinary rod that looks all right and an extraordinary one that feels and acts right. Here we note the installation of tip tops on the pre-aligned rods. The tops are filled with an adhesive mixture, and the adhesive is melted over a flame to ensure permanent bonding. The rod is inserted into the top and then dipped into water to chill. Not even the wiliest and most active fish will blow this top. Both guides and tip tops are precisely and beautifully wrapped by skilled and painstaking wrappers. Moving faster than the eye can follow, the metal guides are wrapped with colored braided nylon over an underwrap to secure tremendous strength. The nylon thread is impregnated in a color-fast solution, so that it will retain its beauty as well as its durability in spite of salt water, sun, and other elements. The completed job is indicative of durability, of strength that will last. Fishing equipment for the utmost in sport has traveled a long way from the farm boy's willow twig and bent pin days.